Everything that I have dealt with till this point, every step has been towards that belt. And nobody, not the skanks that think they're taking it from me tonight, are gonna get in my way.
Gentlemen, welcome to OCW's Women's Championship Tournament. It's your current reigning defending Ohio Heritage Champion, No Shame Jimmy Shane here, and I saw him looking over the microphone, and I decided I'd grab it, and here we got Super Oprah versus Laura Loveless. Whoa! See, that's Laura. power is clearly outstrength here. Outmatched. I don't. Can out wrestle, but I mean, she's clearly learning here that the power behind Super Oprah is not something to be messed with. I'll be joined shortly by my broadcast colleague, Matt Fantone. But for now, I'm just enjoying watching Laura get a. That's loud here, right? I'm not sure. I think there might be kind of a foreign object play here. Laura's trying. Purple Nurple. I've never seen that one before. I'm going to be honest with you. Laura made Oprah angry. That's a. This is not a position Laura wants to be in. We've previously seen Laura Loveless twice here at the OCW Arena. I'm a little worried this might be the last time we've seen her after this one. Oh, and what's Ripper Blackheart doing out here? I want to see it. Do it, Oprah. Do it. Oh, the lip lock. Ripper's in love. Hey, whoa. Ripper just sprayed something in Super Oprah's eyes. Laura Loveless with a flatliner. Loveless put out the victory against Super Oprah. It just shows you having Ripper Blackheart as your manager is always going to pay out for you. He knows every trick in the book, and he's going to use them to your advantage. For that, Laura Loveless has advanced to the semifinals. I think that's not the way you want to do it.
Has come to OCW for one thing and one thing only, and that is the Women's Championship Tournament. And at the end of the night, I'm gonna be the Queen of the Ring.
Hey all, it's Katie Arquette, the Queen of the Silver Screen. I'm here at Ohio Championship Wrestling, and you are looking at the new champion. Just you wait.
Now, as promised, I am now joined by Matt Fantone here at the commentary position.
An absolute pleasure to be here, Jimmy Shane. Ohio Championship Wrestling, the women's division. We're crowning a new champion tonight. I'm super excited about it. I just saw the first match, and surprise, surprise, River Blackheart up to no good as always.
You had to figure he was. I saw him here earlier walking around, scouting talent. I know for a fact he was not with Laura Loveless until just now.
Always looking for a situation to exploit that Ripper is, and honestly, that's one of the things I've been talking with Ohio Championship Wrestling officials about, you know, the integrity of what's going on out there. And if Ripper's going to keep pulling moves like that, it's just not acceptable.
And speaking of integrity, we have here is Big Mama. Now, Big Mama's been in the business for a while, and I know she has all the tools to become champion by herself, but I have to imagine she's going to take a few shortcuts.
You know, everyone's desperate for their opportunity when it comes to the OCW Women's Championships. I would not be surprised.
It's a sweet airbrush jacket, though. I really like it.
And her opponent comes to us from Hollywood, California. She is the queen of the silver screen, Katie Arquette.
Person beyond commentary team, but since I'm not officially part of the commentary staff, I'm gonna say it. There's my pick to win, Katie Arquette.
Jimmy Shane with a bold prediction. Katie Arquette, you know, coming from Hollywood, I'm sure she's been with some of the best trainers and the best athletes in the world. We'll see how she squares up against Big Mama.
And she's the dark horse in this because she wasn't announced for the tournament. She was a last minute replacement for Jinx.
The OCW crowd not buying into what Big Mama's selling.
Cheering. I'm sorry. I'm not excited. I might be smitten. I'm gonna be honest.
Well, the OCW crowd and Jimmy Shane, they do approve.
I felt that up here.
I believe that did. It was on the Richter scale. That registered. Katie Arquette just simply being overpowered by Big Mama.
For it again. You gotta start thinking. She knows she can't outstrength Big Mama.
It's an uphill battle, there's no question about it. Perhaps she's trying to lure Big Mama into a false sense of security.
There she goes. Go for the crucifix pin. It's that size of Big Mama.
The strength of that woman, just to hold Katie Arquette on her shoulders like that, is simply amazing.
And the ring awareness of Big Mama to know to get right out of the ring. Like I said, she's gonna take shortcuts, she's gonna complain, but she's been in this business long enough that she knows what to do.
That is a veteran's move right there from Big Mama.
Oh my God.
timeouts in wrestling?
As far as I know, Jimmy, you know better than I. There are no timeouts, especially here in the OCW arena.
Might pull this one off. She keeps moving that quickly and getting the best of Big Mama. We might have a women's champion on our hands. There's the mistake. She started to trade blows.
Like I said, Katie Arquette from Hollywood, California, worked with some of the best trainers in the world, but still, I don't know if she has the strength to take Big Mama like that.
And there's one of those shortcuts I was talking about. Big Mama choking with her foot.
Chop from Big Mama. Katie Arquette with some counter offense.
I'm impressed. This is her OCW debut, and she's already got the OCW arena behind her.
Well, just like every other championship, I think the OCW arena and the OCW universe, they're looking for a champion with integrity, but I think Big Mama has other plans in mind.
There's that choke. Now, I know I haven't always played by the rules, but...
Well, Jimmy, I think you know better than anybody. Wrestling is a what-have-you-done-for-me-now business, so... Oh. Brutal.
I hope she didn't hurt that pretty little face.
It looks like the real pain might be coming. Katie Arquette trapped in the corner.
Look, good on Keith Smith for not letting her go in right there because he knew they were in the corner. He's still got some fight left in her.
That might have been a desperation kick out though, Jimmy. Katie Arquette trying to wheel her way back into this fight. But once again, the size and strength, the Big Mama, it just may be too much to overcome. Oh, Katie Arquette, hard into the corner.
I wouldn't want to be up. She took Big Mama off her feet.
And Katie Arquette with new life.
At first, you don't succeed. Hey, I'll allow it.
Katie Arquette with the spear to finish off Big Mama.
I'm in love.
You and the entire OCW universe right there. Katie Arquette, an impressive victory and winning over the fan base here at OCW. I think this is the first time I've seen Pavarotti in Akron.
OCW Women's Division, the witch is back. Tonight,
London Only, the exalted one, is going to take home Ohio Championship's women's title. And you know what? That's going to be exalted.
Average Gloom making her return to the OCW arena after she was last here in February against Laura Loveless.
An absolutely bewitching entrance by Miss Gloom.
And London Ali pulling attitude like that, which in Northeastern Ohio you expect out of someone from Pittsburgh, right?
Right, I was going to say, I'm sure she's a Steelers fan as well. Talking trash already to the OCW arena. You're not going to gain much respect like that.
But it's going to have people talking about you. You got to keep that in mind, too. I'm not sure which side I fall on this. You know, I've wanted to run my mouth. I've wanted to bend the rules. But I've been changing my attitude a little bit lately. And
I think it's been appreciated by the OCW, crowd, Jimmy. I think if you're going to wear the title of the Ohio Heritage Champion, it needs to be worn with respect and honor, just like the Women's Championship, hopefully, will be worn with respect and honor.
And that's what I like to see, is if you get disrespected, you take the fight to them. And that's what Everest Gloom did right there. Gloom isn't going to wait any longer.
Oh! Ali using the ropes to her advantage there.
That might be enough. Pulling the hair. I'm surprised we haven't seen more of that in this tournament so far. the hair's there in a pool, and London Holly's the first one to take advantage of it.
Ali looking to and put some damage on to Avarice.
Not even bothering to go for the cover there when she had it, just wanting to put in punishment on Avarice Gloom.
You know, I was backstage prior to the event, and it was very clear that London Ali was not here to make friends. She's here to win this match and win the Ohio Championship Wrestling Women's Championship.
And I know I said earlier my pick was Katie Arquette, but London Ali's impressing me right now.
That was a desperation kick out.
So you have, when you want to be OCW Women's Champion, you're going to be desperate. You're going to have take any opportunity you can to try to bring life back into you. But with the skill set that London Ali clearly has, you have to wonder, is enough enough?
Seems like every time that Avarice Gloom gets some momentum going, London Ali ready with the counterpunch.
Both of them have the same thing in mind, and now they're both down. This is Gloom's chance. This is what she needs, that little breather to turn momentum back in her favor.
You hear the Ohio Championship Wrestling Arena get behind Gloom. We'll see if she's got what it takes. Big clothesline. Another. Gloom even hooked both legs, which shows you how much fight London Ali has in her. I don't even think Avarice Gloom realizes what happened.
She took just a little too long to set that one up, and London Ali capitalized on it.
And that's what all these ladies are looking to do tonight, is to find their opponent making a mistake and capitalize on it. London Ali able to do that in the victory over Avarice Gloom.
Tournament. That belt is pretty, but it'll look prettier when it's on my shoulder.
Zoe Sky here. It's my night, Ohio Championship Wrestling. Ladies, I hope you brought your A game, because I sure did. It's my night to fight this for me.
Jocelyn Navarro against the Rocket Girl, Zoe Sky.
And you know, obviously the Rocket Girl, a fan favorite already here in the OCW arena. We'll see what she can do against Miss Navarro.
Now, as Mr. OCW and the Ohio Heritage Champion, I know a bit about my OCW history. And back in the day, Zoe Sky's actually a veteran of this business. She's competed in OCW before.
You know, Ohio Championship Wrestling, when they decided to revitalize the female wrestling brand, they went out and got the best of the best, and that obviously includes Miss Zoe Sky.
That's not to count out Jocelyn Navarro, though. She has only been in this a few years, less than two, if I'm right. But she has been all over the Midwest lately. And she's showing why right there.
So is Sky able to counter the hold? And tosses Navarro. And again. And it seems clear Jocelyn Navarro having a little bit too much of Zoe Sky. Oh! Zoe Sky feeding off the energy of the crowd.
And Jocelyn Navarro taking advantage of the situation.
Navarro even showing attitude to Keith Smith.
Like that. Zoe Sky once again feeding off the energy of the crowd. From the top rope!
I'm impressed that Navarro was able to kick out of that.
She's a gritty competitor, Jimmy. These women are fighting for the biggest prize in all of Ohio Championship Wrestling, the OCW female title. Frankly, neither can I. I thought that would have been enough to put Zoe Sky away.
She needs to be careful not to let that temper get the best of her, though. That's where mistakes happen. I would know. I've thrown quite a few temper tantrums here in the SW Arena.
Zoe Sky advancing.
I'm ready for the next round already. the semifinals with Laura Loveless against Katie Arquette.
Katie Arquette with a show of good faith here, a show of sportsmanship. Let's see. No surprise there. An associate of River Blackheart, Miss Loveless over there, exhibiting some poor sportsmanship, to say the least.
What's Laura have in mind here?
A classic show of strength here. Katie Arquette, not one to back down from a challenge. Pressure of her own on Miss Loveless.
Seeing some wrestling here. Until Laura takes a shortcut like that, stepping on her toes.
Well, Jimmy, like I said, you know, I don't know much about Laura Loveless, but I do know any associate of Ripper Blackheart, they're always going to be looking to take the easy way out. Always looking for the shortcut home.
Katie Arquette might have the tools to counteract that shortcut.
You know, Jimmy, I saw you talking to Katie backstage prior to the event. What was on her mind?
She is ready to win this. You know, she has a huge opportunity. She wasn't supposed to be in this tournament. And now she can come in, and she's well on her way to become OCW Women's Champion. And we haven't mentioned yet, the OCW Women's Champion, the lineage of it, we have had some impressive former women's champions. They almost all have gone on to greater success.
You can see it in Laura Loveless's face right there, just the mean streak that has just become synonymous with all the associates of Ripper Blackheart. Just laying the boots on.
I hate to talk about Ripper Blackheart and what his associates in him have been capable to do, but look at Grant Andrews ever since Ripper Blackheart got with him. Grant Andrews has taken it up a notch ever since he got Ripper Blackheart.
You know, Ripper Blackheart is putting together quite the impressive stable of ne'er-do-wellers and despicable villains, I would say. You know, the only thing that might be bigger than Ripper's rogues gallery of villains might be his collection of ugly shirts. I mean, look at that thing, Jimmy. What is that?
His closet's just full of those. It's the most disgusting closet you've ever seen in your life. And those are some disgusting tactics by Laura Loveless. Smooth transition by Jimmy Shane there. I was talking about the history and the lineage of the OCW Women's Championship. I think Laura Loveless has already taken more, like, underhanded tactics than any woman in the history of the championship.
Loveless just woman handling Katie Arquette.
He's still got some fight left in her, though.
Katie Arquette with the cover. No River surprise there.
Katie, keep your eyes on Laura, Katie.
Oh, double axe handle to the back. One, two.
much as I wanted Katie to pull out the win, I'm not surprised that Ripper Blackheart helps Laura Loveless get it again.
You know, that's the second match that Loveless had to count on Blackheart's dirty tactics to help her win. But when she did, and heading to the finals in the Ohio Championship Wrestling Women's Championship Tournament.
Concerned about the bell at all?
That's what the OCW Women's Championship means to these women.
I mean, Ali not even giving Zoe a chance to get ready. A despicable move. This thing might be over already.
Like I said, London Ali is the one who I knew the least about coming into this tournament, and she has impressed me the most. And I think we could be looking at the next women's champion right here.
With a big suplex there. And Zoe kicks out at two.
Something must have happened at the back to make London Ali mad. This is about more than just winning the championship.
You know, like you said, Jimmy, London Ali came in here as a newcomer, and she's looking to prove who she is and what she's all about, and that is obviously winning the Ohio Championship Wrestling women's title. Oh! And Zoe Sky might be out. referee giving Zoe Sky a chance to quit here.
Zoe Sky managing the whole con and shows she got some life left in her.
You know, Jimmy, since this thing has started, it just seems like Zoe hasn't had a chance to catch any grounding. And if Ali keeps this up, she might be on her way to winning that OCW Women's Championship.
And a big part of winning a match is momentum. If you get the ball rolling in your corner, you pick up steam, you can roll the person over. And Zoe's guy's not even getting a chance to get any momentum right now. Her rocket may be out of fuel, so to speak.
Zoe Sky looking to build something, anything here. Big clothesline. Once again, headed up high where she's so comfortable.
London Ali continuing to those vicious strikes that have done so well for her so far.
You know, it's obvious that London has done her homework here. She knows where Zoe's most comfortable in the ring, and that's high flying. She's aiming to keep her grounded right now. Zoe Sky.
And let's be honest, she's not going into a one-on-one match in the finals. She's going in to fight Laura Loveless and Ripper Blackheart.
Championship wrestling right there. You got Grant Andrews and the Italian Icon.
Introducing first from Akron, Ohio, weighing 165 volts, Electric Jay Neely, and his tag team partner from Canton, Ohio, weighing 240 pounds, Chuck the Truck Morris.
special attraction here featuring the Spine Buster University students. And keep in mind, Electric Jake Ely and Chuck the Shark Morris are owed a tag team title shot soon.
You know, the current OCW tag team champions, the Dirty, not in attendance tonight, but I'm sure they'll be watching to see what Chuck and Jake have in store.
It's not all about you, Grant.
Good luck telling Grant Andrews that.
I try all the time.
You know, Jimmy, I know that, you know, Grant Andrews once upon a time looked at you as, you know, a mentor, as somebody that could teach him about the business. But this attitude change, it's an all-new Grant Andrews.
I hate to say it. Grant reminds me of a younger me. And a younger me is not someone you want to be.
Well, you don't want to be Grant Andrews.
This is only our second look at Gino DiCapo right now.
You know, he calls himself the Italian icon.
Jake Ely taking out both of them by himself.
You know, Jake's young, he's quick, he's full of energy, and he's ready to prove himself here in the OCW arena. Gino with a big suplex right there.
Yet I wonder what Ely was thinking there, because Ely's the one who hooked the suplex, and he didn't even get a chance. Gino just threw him right over.
The Italian icon, desperate to make a name for himself here in OCW. You know, there's rumors in the back that he has mob ties.
I've heard those rumors, but I've heard that he can neither confirm nor deny those rumors. So I'm a little concerned to ask.
You know, the last thing you'd want to do is end up swimming with the fishes or something of that nature, Jimmy, so I completely understand.
Ely just used static electricity in the rain to shock Gino.
Oh, Grant Andrews. You know, Gino, he's a brutal man, and just not a nice bone in his body, and he's proven that, taking the boots to Electric Ely.
Gino talks about how he thrives on violence, and he's showing it right now. But yeah, I was a little concerned of how this team is going to work out, because Gino thrives on violence, and Grant thrives on himself.
Style offense there from the Italian icon of Grant Andrews. Two count. And Ely able to kick out there. One, two.
I have felt that very knee from Grant Andrews before. I'm surprised that Ely was able to get up.
From Grant Andrews, you know, keeping Jake Ely on the ropes, attacking Chuck the Truck Morris in the corner.
It's supposed to be a tag team match, but Gino and Grant have made it a handicap match. Chuck hasn't got anything in right now.
Grant and Gino must have came up with a game plan. The last thing they want to do is deal with Chuck the Truck Morris, which is why you see Grant Andrews continue to take the cheap shot on him.
keep in mind, Ely's greatest strength is his heart. He's going to feed off the electricity here in the OCW Arena, and they need to keep him down, because if he gets moving, it's hard to stop him.
Have it, but Grant Andrews letting the truck have it. Slam from the Italian icon there. And now it just looks like they're toying with him.
They're just having fun beating up on the smallest person in their training class. This could be very much be it.
You know, Jimmy, I don't know if Jake Ely even knows where he is right now, but he knows that he's not going to give up.
I've seen Grant win matches with that move.
Oh, this could be it, Jimmy. This could be it. Grant Andrews, he's got to lock in deep, and there's no way that Jake Ely's getting to those ropes.
Ely's got heart, but who has this much heart to be able to get out of this one?
Look at him, he's practically bent in half.
Ely's got to make it over that corner.
Referee up to seven. Truck is coming through, baby!
Someone's about to come roadkill here.
Chuck Morris just manhandling Grant Andrews. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking! Strength of Chuck!
Grant Andrews doing anything he can to stop Chuck.
That's something I've never seen from Ely before.
A power move from Ely. These two big men squaring off in the center of the ring. Oh! A shot to the throat from the Italian icon.
Homage to their trainer right there, Sherman Tank. What do they have in mind here?
Here's that tandem style offense.
these two are still owed a shot at the OCW Tag Team titles. And if I was the Dirty, I'd be concerned.
We might be looking at future champions right here.
OCW Women's Championship. Neither one of these women at 100%. There's no question about it. But considering the shortcuts that Laura has taken tonight, I've got to say, she probably has the advantage over Zoe Sky.
But you can feel that something special in the air right now. We're about to see history. We're about to see the crowning of a brand new OCW Women's Champion.
Oh, and no surprise there, Laura Lovelace starting things out with a cheap shot.
Guarantee Laura watched that last match and knows that Zoe is down and out almost. But it only was aggressive in there.
And we can't forget the Ripper Blackheart factor. No matter what Zoe Sky does out there, she's still going to have a set of eyes in the back of her head almost, keeping an eye on Ripper Blackheart.
Right there, Zoe doesn't seem too worried about Ripper Blackheart. So she might have something up her sleeve.
Well, that might prove to be a mistake, Jimmy. Zoe with the two count. Loveless able to kick out. Zoe Sky building up energy. Zoe definitely not the biggest woman in tonight's tournament, but she's able to use her body in creative ways. days. I mean, look at that momentum.
The name Rocket Girl is so fitting.
Taking advantage of every opportunity she has to stretch the rules.
I'm starting hurt watching the beating Dolores put it on Angel Dust right now.
Insulting there, Laura Loveless, with a one-footed pin.
That's what you have to expect from client of Ripper Blackheart.
Zoe Sky moving out of the way.
Turning things in her favor now. Just hope she can capitalize on this.
One, two. Thought for a second we had a new women's champion.
As much as Lauren Loveless is going to take shortcuts and going to take underhanded tactics like Rick Blackheart's selling her to, I know that Lauren Loveless is going to put in more fight than that. That was the move that Zoe won her first match with, but clearly Laura was watching the monitors in the back.
You know, say what you want about Ripper Blackheart, he does his homework when it comes to his entourage's opponents.
You're right. Laura could have been, every other person in this tournament had to sit and watch the monitor. Laura could go, she could rest, she could stretch, she could ice up, and Ripper Blackheart could be one, two, three. Oh, what a kick there.
Once again, Zoe Sky headed to the top rope where she is oh so comfortable. We've got an oh! No surprise there. Ripper Blackheart grabbing the ankle of Zoe Sky, holding her back.
He's holding on.
Oh!
Zoe Sky was able to move.
And suddenly, the Ripper Blackheart factor has been neutralized. Zoe Sky in an absolutely helpless position right here.
That is not a spot you want to be in.
Laura Loveless free to do as she pleases. At the last second, Zoe Sky able to dodge that one. Oh!
Three! We have a new women's champion!
An absolutely amazing display of athleticism there by Zoe Sky! Women's champion.